Flemings right hand rule. In the previous video, we have learned about Flemings left hand rule. So now we are going to study about the Flemings right hand rule. Flemings right hand rule is used to find direction of induced electromagnetic field generated. So what the law states? According to Flemings right hand rule, the thumb, forefinger and middle finger of the right hand are stretched perpendicular to each other as shown in the image, and the thumb represents the direction of the movement of the conductor, forefinger represents the direction of the magnetic field, and then the middle finger represents the direction of the induced current. So here in the image you can clearly see that the thumb is representing the direction of the movement of the conductor, the forefinger represents the direction of the magnetic field, and then the middle finger is representing the direction of the induced current. Now, we'll learn about the various uses of Flemings right hand rules. Electric generator is a very good example of Flemings right hand rule. So, what is the principle of electric generator? The electric generator is a machine that converts one form of energy into another, especially mechanical energy into electrical energy. So this is the function of electric generators. So what is the principle of the electric generator? The generator is an application of electromagnetic induction. It works on the principle that when a wire is moved in a magnetic field, then the current is induced in the coil. A rectangular coil is made to rotate rapidly in the magnetic field between the poles of a horseshoe type magnet. When the coil rotates, it cuts the lines of the magnetic force due to which a current is produced in the generator coil. The current can be used to run the various electrical appliances. Now, the construction of the electric generator. A simple electric generator, or you can say a DC generator, consists of a rectangular coil ABCD which can be rotated rapidly between the poles north and south of a strong horseshoe type magnet. The generator coil is made up of a large number of turns of insulated copper wire. The one end of the coil is connected to the copper half ring R1 and the other end of the coil is connected to the copper half ring R2. When the coil is rotated, the two half rings R1 and R2 touch the two carbon brushes B1 and B2 one by one. So the current produced in the rotating coil can be taped out through the commutator half rings and into the carbon brushes. From the carbon brushes B1 and B2 we can supply current into various electrical appliances. So here in the image you can see the north pole and the south pole of a strong horseshoe type magnet. So here this is your R1 and R2, the half rings. This is your R1, this is your R2, look at the image. Then this is your B1, brush 1 and brush 2. So here we can connect the appliances and we can supply the current from here only, B1 and B2. How the electric generators work? Let us suppose that the generator coil ABCD is initially in the horizontal position. As the coil rotates in the anticlockwise direction between north and south poles of the magnet, the sides of AB of the coil moves down, cutting the magnetic lines of force near the north pole of the magnet, and side DC move up, cutting the lines of force near the south pole of the magnet. Due to this, the induced current is produced in the sides AB and DC of the coil. So here it is the AB and it is the DC. On applying Flemings right hand rule to the sides AB and DC of the coil, we find that the current in the two sides of the coil are in the same direction and we get an effective induced current in the direction BADC. Due to this, the brush B1 becomes the positive pole and brush B2 becomes the negative pole of the generator. After half revolution, the sides AB and DC of the coil will interchange their position. The side AB will come on the right hand side and starts moving up, whereas side CD will come on the left hand side and starts moving down. But when the sides of the coil interchange their positions, then the two commutator rings R1 and R2 automatically change their contacts from one carbon brush to other. Due to this change, the current keeps flowing in the same direction, thus a DC generator supplies current only in one direction. So guys, we have just discussed about the Fleming's right hand rule and its applications in electric generators. Hope you all like this video. Thanks for watching us.